Welcome back. Sealy has partnered with Hockey Canada to sponsor the women's national team at the International Ice Hockey Federation Women's World Championship. Their initiative, Hockey is Hers, encourages more young girls and women into the sport of hockey. Hockey has an undeniable positive impact on the people who play, and those impacts should be shared by all, regardless of gender. So in support of this amazing initiative, one lucky viewer will get a chance to win this Hockey Canada home mattress that is available exclusively at Leon's. I can attest to the comfort of a Sealy mattress. I sleep on one myself. Everything about this amazing mattress screams hockey, right down to the Sealy Max Ice fabric and center ice memory foam. Its firm cushion and a tight top will help you score a restful and supportive sleep. The incredible prize that I just mentioned, courtesy of Sealy, is valued at $599. So what you need to do is go to cityline.tv, click on daily prizing for your chance to win. So we thought the sentiment behind Sealy's initiative is actually a really good topic for us to talk about here on Cityline. I'm a mom of a daughter in hockey, and I have a little bit of experience on the subject. I spent a lot of time in arenas now, and Eva absolutely loves it. Stacy Irvine's with us. You've put in the hours, for sure. You've got three kids, and they're all over the place in their extracurriculars, but all three of them play hockey.
Yes. Yep.
And then neither of us has clocked as much rink time as this hockey mom of 20 years. Also, one of our WLC 10 challengers, Anji Sharp, is with us as well. So as soon as I knew we were talking about girls in hockey, I was like, Anji, because I see on Instagram, I see your goalie daughter. And when I say to you, you know, did you ever see your life differently? Your answer is nope.
No.
You've been doing hockey arenas from what age?
The boys are 25, so when they were five, so 20 years at least in the rink.
Amazing.
Yep, consistently, no break.
Was it tough at all for either of you to get your kids into sports, or was that just a natural?
For me, it was definitely a natural, and it's funny because being from out west, football was the big sport, and neither my husband or I had experience in hockey. And so we were surprised when they chose hockey. And so it was a massive learning curve to manage hockey in this type of arena.
Yes.
But it's been fantastic.
It has been.
I love seeing the girls excel through hockey. Mm-hmm. It's one of the most rewarding things to watch. I think it's just heartwarming.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, you know, having that great community with other girls, I think, is beautiful. Mm-hmm. Anji, I'd love to know from you just about balancing the schedule. Like, how do you do that with your hockey girls?
It's not easy, but it's especially because they do play the high level, so they've got practices once or twice a week, and then games twice a week, tournaments. So we really don't have a balance. We just go with the flow and just, you know, you get team snap and get the calendar and you just add it to the calendar and just, I mean, that's how we function. We just look at where we are the day. It's hard. It's very hard to flow it easily.
Team snap is a lifesaver.
It's everything.
And carpool.
Do you talk at all with your girls about any of the struggles that they have in sport? Are they open about that? Do they have any struggles, or is it the same? Do you have the same conversation with your girls as you do with your boys?
I think with the girl, like with my daughter, it's a similar conversation. The stress, I think, can be very similar.
Yeah.
I find the nice thing about girls' sports is they're very supportive of each other in the team, and I find with the boys they're a little more competitive.
True.
It's a bit of a different vibe, and even when they're playing against other girls, they kind of like to hang out with those girls too. Like I see them chatting and you're like, that's the competition. But which is wonderful. The boys aren't so much like that. They come up with like wicked stories about the other team and that don't like that guy. But I don't find that with the girls. It's a different vibe.
It's definitely a different vibe, and it's a different, you know, we've never treated the girls differently than the boys in terms of what opportunities we want to give them,
mm-hmm.
but we have said in terms of with the boys, there's always the next level to go to, so they're always working hard to go to the OHL or then to go to the NHL if that's their dream, but with the girls, you're kind of left with like, well, at least if you're having fun and you're happy, which is what you want for your kid to have fun and be happy.
Yeah.
But you can't, like, where's the next level?
Wouldn't it be amazing if there was another level?
So that's what we have found different with the boys and the girls. The boys, it was the work hard for this level, work hard for that level. Girls, it's have fun. You know, and it's great. They do have fun, but there isn't that to have that next level. Or we can't ever say that girls, you know, I have had to say to my girls, you're never going to make a living playing hockey. Unfortunately, not in their lifetime. But the boys
could. Enjoy it, have fun with it, make great connections, because absolutely, you're talking about very different things when it comes to boys and girls.
Hopefully it'll change,
and hopefully the conversations are happening about parity and all sorts of things and scholarships. But I'm really happy that they can get out there, because what I hear from other moms is, we only had Ringette. And now they actually have an opportunity to get on that ice and play hockey, which is incredible.